When we first arrived, we were still distressed by what's happening in Syria. I started crying every time I thought of Syria.
Rhonda and Naroz made their journey to the United States in December 2015. While they were excited, their transition wasn't as easy as they thought it would be.
I had no goal. Everyone speaks English and I don't know what they're talking about. I asked God to help me speak English like them.
Being younger, Naroz didn't remember vividly the brutality going on in Syria. She was much more optimistic about her new life.
I came here because of the war in my country. I came to study. I came to make America better. I came to have a future.
But school was difficult, especially for the older sister.
I was older than the other students. They ask me about my age. I tell them I'm 17 years old. I ask the same question. They reply 12 or 13 years old. They didn't initially understand why a 17-year-old girl could be in the seventh grade.
With dad disabled and mom taking care of Alan, their brother who has cerebral palsy, Rhonda was next in line to work. She had to drop out of school. For Naroz, it was a lot easier.
Everything about school is to have friends. I have a lot of friends at school and in my apartment, in my neighborhood. So I have a lot of friends. I make them because I can talk to them. But before, I don't have any because I don't know English.
2 years later, the girls are finally feeling a bit of normalcy. With the civil war behind them, they have just one ultimate wish.
I want to become a doctor because I want to help all of the children in the world. It does not matter where they're from or what is their race. I'm just going to help them.
My dream is to make something out of myself and make my family proud. My parents told me that I'm in an important stage of my life, that I need to make good use of it. I'll make every effort to be successful and give back.